हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। इन दी वीडियो नंबर 6 इन यस्टरडेज वन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड थर्ड कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी, दैट इज ए डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट। इन द डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट वी हैव स्टडीड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, देन व्हाट इज मीन बाय फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, एंड फाइनली वी आर अराइव्ड अप टू डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ मोलार मास ऑफ नॉन होलाटाइल नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट सोल्यूट यूजिंग दैट कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट। एंड नाउ दिस इज द लास्ट वन, फोर्थ कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी, दैट इज ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर। सेम एज दैट ऑफ द एलिवेशन ऑफ बॉइलिंग पॉइंट एंड डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर ऑल्सो हैज डायरेक्ट कॉन्सिक्वेंस विद द वेपर प्रेशर। वी नो वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ सॉल्वेंट इज ग्रेटर दैन द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ सोल्यूशन। दिस ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर हैज ए डायरेक्ट कॉन्सिक्वेंस विद द वेपर प्रेशर। सेम एज दैट ऑफ द एलिवेशन ऑफ बॉइलिंग पॉइंट एंड डिप्रेशन ऑफ फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट, देयरफॉर दिस इज ऑल्सो यूज्ड फॉर डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ मोलर मास ऑफ नॉन होलाटाइल नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट सोल्यूट। इन दिस ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर एज ए फोर्थ कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी द इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म्स इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स वी हैव टू स्टडी आर सेमी, व्हाट इज मीन बाय सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन, व्हाट इज ऑस्मोसिस, व्हाट इज ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर, व्हाट इज मीन बाय आइसोटोनिक सोल्यूशन, हाइपरटोनिक सोल्यूशन, हाइपोटोनिक सोल्यूशन, एंड फाइनली वी हैव टू स्टडी सर्टन लॉज नोन एज वेंट ऑफ बॉयल्स लॉ, वेंट ऑफ चार्ल्स लॉ फॉर डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ मोलर मास ऑफ नॉन होलाटाइल नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट सोल्यूट, एंड देन रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस एंड द यूज ऑफ रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस, दैट इज व्हाट वी हैव टू स्टडी अंडर द यूनिट ऑफ फोर्थ कोलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर। सो लेट अस सी वन बाय वन। What is meant by semi-permeable membrane? It is the membrane which allows the passage of only solvent molecules through itself, but not a solute. Semi-permeable membrane is the membrane which allows the passage of only solvent through itself, but not a solute, is known as semi-permeable membrane. So why it takes place? Why semi-permeable membrane allows the passage of only solvent but not solute? It is because semi-permeable membrane has a certain pores. It has the certain pores. Holes. Holes are there. Pores are there to the semi-permeable membrane. The size of that pores is bigger. It is a bigger one which will allow the solvent molecules. But this size is a smaller than the size of solute molecules. You got it? Why semi-permeable membrane allows the passage of only solvent and not solute? Because it has pores. And the size of that pores is so bigger that it allows the passage of solvent. But it is so smaller that it will not allow the passage of solute molecules. The size of solute molecule, in other words, is bigger as compared with the pore size of semi-permeable membrane. And the size of solvent molecules is smaller as compared with the size of pores of the semi-permeable membrane. Therefore, semi-permeable membrane allows the passage of only solvent through itself but not a solute molecules. That is the important property of semi-permeable membrane. So that is about the semi-permeable membrane. It is the membrane which allows the passage of only solvent through itself but not a solute. Secondly, we have to study what is meant by osmosis and osmotic pressure. Now that is the important point over here. See what is meant by osmosis. Let us see this diagram. In this diagram, it is divided into two compartments. I have divided this apparatus into two compartments. In one compartment, we have taken a pure solvent. In the another compartment, there we have taken a solution. No doubt, this is a colligative property. And the solvent used over here is water. Because colligative properties are the properties which are depending on the number of solute particle, not on the nature or size of solute particle. They are the properties of non-volatile, non-electrolyte solute. They are the properties of very dilute solution, which has concentration less than 0.2 molar. They are the properties of only aqueous solution. So here, the solvent used in both cases, over here is a water. This instrument, apparatus, is divided into two compartments. In one compartment, I have taken a pure solvent. In the another compartment, I have taken a solution. And solvent and solution are separated by one membrane known as a semi-permeable membrane. This part is known as a semi-permeable membrane. On this side, a piston is applied, weightless and frictionless piston is applied. On this side also, a weightless and frictionless piston is applied. On both sides, it is a weightless and frictionless piston. Now see what happens whenever the process is started. What is meant by osmosis? This is our assembly. Whenever the assembly is completed, semi-permeable membrane has the property that it allows the passage of only solvent through itself but not a solute. Now the phenomenon of osmosis will be started. See how osmosis takes place. This semi-permeable membrane at the center, it is allowing the passage of solvent through itself from solvent side to the solution side. There is a flow of solvent molecule taking place from solvent to the solution. At the same time, solvent is present on the right side also. Solvent is present in the solution side also. That solvent is also moving over here. Movement of solvent from pure solvent compartment into the solution compartment takes place. In the similar manner, movement of solvent from solution compartment to the pure solvent compartment also takes place. Both way it is taking place. But it is observed that the net rate of flow of solvent from pure solvent compartment to the solution compartment is bigger. This flow from left to right is greater as compared with the flow of solvent from right to the left. This is bigger one. Therefore, what is the net flow? Net flow of solvent taking place from pure solvent compartment to the solution compartment through a semi-permeable membrane, that is known as phenomenon of osmosis. You got it? It is the spontaneous and unidirectional flow of pure solvent from a solvent compartment to the solution compartment. That is a net flow. I have told you over here that flow is not taking place in only one direction. It is taking place in both directions, because here is a solvent, here also solvent is present in the solution. So flow of solvent from solvent to solution as well as solution to solvent also take place. But finally, what is the important point? The important point is that net flow of solvent from solvent compartment to the solution compartment is bigger, because rate of passage, rate of flow of solvent from solvent compartment to the solution compartment is bigger as compared with the flow of solvent from solution compartment to the solvent compartment. Therefore, the net flow is the flow of solvent from pure solvent compartment to the solution compartment, and that is known as osmosis. On the other hand, instead of pure solvent and a solution, If we consider this also a solution, this is also a solution. If this is a solution of one molarity and this is a solution of 10 molarity. Now what I have done? I have separated two solutions by a semi-permeable membrane. Here is a solution of lower concentration and here is a solution of higher concentration. These two solutions are separated from each other by a semi-permeable membrane. At this time also, osmosis take place. Now, how osmosis take place? I have told you, there is the movement of solvent taking place from pure solvent compartment to the solution compartment. But here, pure solvent is absent. Instead of that, both compartments are containing a solution. But can you tell me in which side the component solvent is greater? It is on the left side. Why? Because concentration is less, means solute is less and solvent is more. Here concentration is 10 molar, means the solute proportion is more and the solvent is less. Therefore, over here, whenever two solutions of two separate concentration are separated from each other by a semi-permeable membrane, one of them has less concentration, other one will have a higher concentration. At that time, here also the movement taking place from lower concentrated solution to the higher concentrated solution. There is a movement of solvent taking place from a solution of lower concentration to a solution of higher concentration through a semi-permeable membrane known as osmosis. So osmosis is the phenomenon of movement of solvent from either a pure solvent compartment to the solution compartment, or a movement of solvent from lower concentrated solution to the higher concentrated solution is known as a phenomenon of osmosis. So here we have studied the osmosis. Now after osmosis, what will happen when your osmosis takes place? This piston comes down. This piston is coming down. Whereas the level of this piston rises. This piston goes up. And why it is going up? Why the level rise up? Because this side has higher osmotic pressure. It has a higher concentration. It has higher vapor pressure. Now see the direct consequence. There is a direct consequence of vapor pressure and osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure has direct consequence with the vapor pressure. This side has higher concentration. This side has lower concentration. Or if this is a pure solvent, this is a solution. Pure solvent has a higher vapor pressure. Higher vapor pressure and less osmotic pressure. This side, which has a higher concentration, has less vapor pressure and higher osmotic pressure. Therefore, this piston goes up. Because of higher osmotic pressure, the level of this piston rises. And as this level rises, osmosis takes place. Osmosis is a continuous process. So spontaneous and unidirectional flow of solvent from a pure solvent compartment to the solution compartment, or from a lower concentrated solution to the higher concentrated solution, is known as osmosis. Due to osmosis, this piston comes down, whereas this piston goes up. Now, what is mean by osmotic pressure? Whenever this piston goes up, and suppose it is stopping at this level, why it stops at this level? Because at that time, certain external pressure is developed on this side, which will stop this penetration. What happened at this level? At this level, certain external pressure is developed on this side such that this flow from left to right is stopped because of the pressure developed over here, and that hydrostatic pressure developed on the higher concentrated solution side piston is known as osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure is a hydrostatic pressure developed on a solution side piston of higher concentration is known as osmotic pressure. Let us see the same phenomenon over here in this one more diagram. Let us consider this is a thistle funnel, inverted thistle funnel, which is filled with a glucose solution immersed in a beaker containing a pure water, and here this thistle funnel is fastened. It is fastened with a semi-permeable membrane. That is the membrane which allows the passage of only solvent through itself but not a solute. So what happens? Once the assembly is completed, we know osmosis takes place. This is solution and here is a solvent. So solvent enters into the solution through a semi-permeable membrane. And this level increases. Initially, this is the level. But due to osmosis, this level increases. And at this level, whenever it is stopped, if the rise is stopped, rise of solution is stopped at this level, means what happens? At this time, certain pressure is developed in the capillary, a certain pressure is developed in this tube, and that pressure stops the movement of solvent into the solution. Due to that pressure, there is the equilibrium obtained in between the solution and solvent, means both sides will have now the same osmotic pressure. And that hydrostatic pressure which is developed on this solution side piston is known as osmotic pressure. That is the hydrostatic pressure developed on higher concentrated solution side piston or a solution side piston whenever compared with the pure solvent is known as osmotic pressure. These are the three important ones, basic terms in osmosis. Now, depending on the movement of solvent and solution through a semi-permeable membrane, there are three type of solutions based on movement of solvent from one compartment to the other compartment. There are three type of solutions. They are known as isotonic solutions, hypertonic solutions and hypotonic solutions. Whenever two solutions which are having same concentration are separated from each other by a semi-permeable membrane, they are known as isotonic solutions with respect to each other. Iso means same. The solutions which are having same concentration, therefore same vapor pressure and same osmotic pressure, neither movement of solution from left to right or right to left taking place, no movement taking place through a semi-permeable membrane, those two type of solutions are known as isotonic solutions with respect to each other. The solutions which are having same concentration, same number of moles of solute, same vapor pressure, same osmotic pressure at a constant temperature, no movement taking place through a semi-permeable membrane, they are known as isotonic solutions. Hypertonic solutions. Let this solution has a concentration of 1 molar, this has 10 molar. Now what will happen? There is movement of solvent from 1 molar to 10 molar take place because this side has higher concentration, higher molarity, lower vapor pressure. Vapor pressure is lower एंड हायर ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर दैट इज नोन एज हाइपरटोनिक सॉल्यूशन. द सॉल्यूशन व्हिच हैज हायर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, लोअर वेपर प्रेशर, हायर ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर एज कंपेयर्ड विद द अदर सॉल्यूशन एट ए गिवन कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर इज नोन एज हाइपरटोनिक सॉल्यूशन. एंड लास्ट वन, दिस इज द हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन. हाइपो मीन्स लो, लोअर साइड. द सॉल्यूशन दिस वन व्हिच हैज लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, दिस सॉल्यूशन हैज ए लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन एज कंपेयर्ड विद द सेकंड वन. सो व्हाट हैपन, मूवमेंट ऑफ सॉल्वेंट टेकिंग प्लेस फ्रॉम लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड सॉल्यूशन टू द हायर कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड सॉल्यूशन थ्रू ए सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन इज नोन एज ऑस्मोसिस. दिस सॉल्यूशन व्हिच हैज लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, लोअर नंबर ऑफ मोल्स, हायर वेपर प्रेशर एंड लोअर ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर इज नोन एज अ हाइपोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन. दीज आर थ्री टाइप ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस एक्सप्लेन्ड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर मूवमेंट थ्रू ए सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन. नाउ हियर इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट वी हैव टू स्टडी, व्हाट इज इट्स एप्लीकेशन, हाउ इट इज अप्लाइड. ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर इज अप्लाइड इन द डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ मोलर मास ऑफ नॉन वोलाटाइल नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट सोल्यूट. लेट अस सी दैट एप्लीकेशन फॉर विच सर्टन लॉज आर देयर. इन द 11th स्टैंडर्ड यू हैव स्टडीड द वाइल्स लॉ एंड चार्ज लॉ. सर्टन कंसेप्ट इज ओवर हियर ऑल्सो. द लॉज एप्लीकेबल आर वेंट ऑफ Boyle's law and the second one is known as Van der Charles law. Let us see what is the Van der Boyle's law. You know, according to Boyle's law for gaseous state, last year you have studied, at constant temperature, pressure exerted by given moles of gases is inversely proportional to hull. Similarly, here also, according to Van der Boyle's law for solutions, at constant temperature, osmotic pressure which has a designation of pi, it is directly proportional to concentration and inversely proportional to volume. What is the Van der Boyle's law? This law is stated that at constant temperature, osmotic pressure of a solution pi is directly proportional to concentration and inversely proportional to volume. We know concentration is inversely proportional to volume. Therefore, osmotic pressure pi is also inversely proportional to volume. The second law, it is the Van der Charles law. According to Van der Charles law, osmotic pressure pi is directly proportional to temperature at a given constant concentration. At a given constant concentration, osmotic pressure pi is directly proportional to temperature. Now combining these two equations, if we combine these two equations, combining these laws, what we can write? We can write that osmotic pressure pi is directly proportional to temperature and inversely proportional to volume. This is the combination. Osmotic pressure pi is directly proportional to temperature and inversely proportional to volume. If some proportionality constant is used, suppose it is pi is equal to RT upon V. R is the proportionality constant and we will get pi V is equal to N2 RT for N2 number of moles of solute. I have told you N2, X2, M2, W2 are the terms used for solute. And X1, N1, W1, M1 are the terms used for a solvent. So N2 is number of moles, constant number of moles of solute. So from this one, we will get this equation pi V is equal to N2 RT. Or we can write like this, pi is equal to N2 upon V into RT. Where this N2 upon V is known as molarity. Now it is capital M. In elevation of boiling point and depression of freezing point, we are using small m. बिकॉज दोज प्रॉपर्टीज आर डिपेंडिंग ऑन द टेम्परेचर, देयर सिस्टम ऑफ डिफरेंट टेम्परेचर वी आर यूजिंग, बट इन ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर इट इज डिटरमाइंड एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर, देर इज नो चेंज इन टेम्परेचर, देयर फॉर इंस्टेड ऑफ मोलैरिटी, मोलैरिटी इज यूज, इवन दो मोलैरिटी वी नो डिपेंड्स ऑन द टेम्परेचर, बिकॉज मोलैरिटी डिपेंड्स ऑन वॉल्यूम एंड वॉल्यूम एंड टेम्परेचर आर डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू ईच अदर, therefore even though molarity depends on volume, even though it depends on the temperature, but since osmotic pressure is studied at constant temperature, therefore instead of molarity, molarity term is used, capital M is used, so this equation will become pi is equal to m r t, or we know n to number of moles of solute is a ratio of mass of solute upon molar mass of solute. If we substitute this equation in this one, let this is equation 2 and this is equation 1, if we substitute equation 2 in equation 1, what we will get? We will get pi is equal to w2 upon m2, w2 upon m2, this is for n2, R T upon V, and from this final equation we will get molar mass of non-volatile non-electrolyte solute M2 is equal to, this is W2 R T upon pi V. So using this equation one can calculate the molar mass of non-volatile non-electrolyte solute using the fourth colligative property, that is osmotic pressure. And the last point from osmotic pressure over here is nothing but the reverse osmosis. We must know what is meant by reverse osmosis and what is the application of reverse osmosis, that is the last point in the fourth colligative property of osmotic pressure. Just now we have studied what is osmosis. Osmosis is spontaneous and unidirectional flow of solvent from a pure solvent compartment to the solution compartment, or from a solution of lower concentration to the solution of higher concentration. That is the osmosis. Now here we are studying reverse osmosis. Reverse, the term itself it is there, reverse. Reverse means opposite. Opposite of osmosis. You must have seen the domestic term RO. In day-to-day life, we are using this term. We are using the water for drinking purpose, which is created using RO. So what is this RO? It is reverse osmosis. And the mechanism of reverse osmosis is used for purification of water. See how it is purified? See the same diagram. Suppose this is the semi-permeable membrane. Here is a salty water. Here we have a salty water which we cannot use for the drinking purpose. And here is a pure water. And these two samples of water are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. At the center, this is the semi-permeable membrane. So what will happen? Once the assembly is completed, there is the flow of solvent from pure solvent compartment to the solution compartment take place. That is known as osmosis. Flow of water from pure solvent, pure water, to the salty water take place. That is the phenomenon of osmosis. But here we are studying the reverse osmosis. Due to osmosis, what happens? This side piston comes down and this side piston goes up because it has a greater pressure, greater osmotic pressure, and this side has a less osmotic pressure. That is known as osmosis. Due to osmosis, there is unidirectional flow of pure water from this compartment to the salty water second compartment take place. This way unidirectional flow take place, that is osmosis, and this piston goes up. What is reverse osmosis? How it is taking place? Now see here, if a pressure is applied on this side, if we apply the external pressure, if we apply external pressure on this side, what happens? If the external pressure is greater than osmotic pressure, if this applied external pressure is greater than the osmotic pressure, at that time reverse flow takes place. There is the flow of only solvent, but from salty water to the pure water takes place, and here we will get the pure water. This level increases, we will get more and more pure water from a salty water by the application of external pressure greater than osmotic pressure. That is known as reverse osmosis, and that reverse osmosis is used for purification of pure water. So with that, we have completed the fourth colligative property, osmotic pressure.